Live from Busch Stadium in St. Louis, Missouri, we've got a perfect day for baseball. It's the Milwaukee Brewers taking on the St. Louis Cardinals. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go now. And for the Cardinals here this afternoon, it's Miles Michaelis. Chris, how about a scouting report?
Well, the hammer is in effect, and he sets it up so nicely because of the velocity on the fastball. We'll elevate that and then break you off when he's ahead in the count. What I love about him, you get into the later innings of the ball game, and the velocity seems to go up.
Up now for Milwaukee, Christian Yelich. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count, 1-2.
Definitely not going to make his highlight tape.
That one just misses the outside corner. 2-2. Ground ball to the right side. And he takes it himself for the out. Here's the Brewers lineup put together by Craig Counsell. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singy.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Swing and a miss. And the count is even, 2-2. One down, base is empty. Out towards right center. That's well struck. That one back there. In one hops off the wall. Should be extra bases. He's in at second with a one out double.
Everything came together for him. Anytime you can drive a ball into the gap the other way, it feels so good. And that's when you know you're right where you need to be at the plate. And it's even better when it gets you extra bases. Love looking in at your dugout and seeing the guys fired up.
And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. That misses the zone. Two balls and a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
One out and a runner at second. Swing and a pop-up. Arenado has a beat on it. Hauls it in for the out.
Batting fourth, the center fielder, number 10, Sal Frelick.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Sal Frelick. Two outs and one in scoring position. Now a high fly ball out to left center. O'Neill getting an angle on it, makes the grab, tracks it down after the long run. And that is that. Brewers strand one. Now the Cardinals will see what they can do. There's no score. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here in St. Louis, today's starting pitcher, Wade Miley.
Well, this guy has the ability to command the game. He's got to limit damage, make his pitches, and avoid that big inning. If he can work around that, he can give a quality start, hand this off to the bullpen later on, and put his team in a position to win a game.
Bottom of the first. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Lars Nootbaar. The 1-1. That one down the line. And a quick out, number one.
Batting second.
Here's a Cardinals lineup now. And here's Paul Goldschmidt. Call me. The 1-1 is fouled off.
He's mixing his pitches really well, late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. The why to kick the pitch. Good eye right there. Got him swinging. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Well, you see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long.
Oh, this is deep to left center. Way back there. On its way. Gone. A solo shot. The Cardinals score first. It's 1-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back.
Singy, this was a mammoth home run, over 460 feet, according to StatCast.
You know, Boog, there are only maybe 20 or so guys in the game that can hit a baseball that far, and it's absolutely crazy it's even that many. Such an impressive swing of the bat right there.
Here's Nolan Arenado. On the ground, right side, sneaks through, base hit. And that gives Wilson Contreras a chance to hit with two out.
Back-to-back base hits. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. The 2-1. Ground ball up the middle. Over to Adames. Third out. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back here at Busch Stadium, top of the second, up now for Milwaukee, Willie Adames. 2-1 now. And that's downstairs and outside. That clips the corner. Patrick Johnson calling the balls and strikes.
Pretty standard zone for Johnson. Sometimes he might get a little jumpy, a little excited and expand the zone, but usually you at least feel like the guy on the mound is earning it. And that's important because you got to make guys earn it.
A rope into right, and that's a base hit.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over it. Absolutely smoked that ball.
Here's Rowdy Tellez. The 3-1. Swing and a drive. Deep center field. On its way. Home run. He blasted that one out of here. And they take the lead. It's 2-1. That was blasted.
Absolutely. No doubt off the bat. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here's Mark Canna. Righty delivers. So now 1-2. And the pitch. Canna tries to hold up. Appeal to first. Got him. Larry Bullard rings him up. This is Bryce Terang. Kicks and deals. That's in there. 1-2 now. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. O'Neill makes the grab, two down.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Next for the Brewers, Andrew Monasterio. The wind of the pitch. Inside, just missed.
As a veteran out there on the bump, you're trying to establish both edges of the plate. Right here, he's working inside.
That's ball off the mark. And now three balls and a strike. The other way, base hit. And that means Christian Yelich will have a chance to hit.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy. Didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep. Took the barrel right to it and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Now it's Christian Yelich. 0-1. He grounded out to first his last time. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
And now it's William Contreras. Doubled his first time up. 1-2 here. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. First and second, two down. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Brewers 2 and the Cardinals 1. Back in St. Louis as the Cardinals come up to hit here in the last of the second, bottom of the second. Now it's the rookie DH, Lucan Baker. That one's in there. And a count 1-2. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. The wind of the pitch. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Got it by him for the K. Tommy Edman at the plate. And a pitch. That one in there across the letters. Wide the kick and the 1-2. Swing and a ball popped up. Terang moving under it. Two down.
Batting it, the right fielder, Jordan Walker.
Now up for St. Louis, Jordan Walker. Two down, nobody on. Ripped to short. Adames, the throw to first. St. Louis goes down in order. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. They're down 2-1. New inning getting started. And here's the first baseman, Carlos Santana.
Carlos Santana.
Here's a 1-1. And that one clips the corner.
Well, these Brewers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
That That's inside. Two balls, two strikes.
Still relatively early, but with the pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set him up to do more damage later in this game.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Sal Frelick, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Steps on the bag for one and two. In time to first for the double play.
Good 6-3 double play right there. Takes it himself. And it's a nice job to work closer to getting out of this inning.
Willie Adames stands in. That just misses. And a count 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
The pitch. That one fouled off. 2-2. And he deals. Misses. And it's 3-2. Got him swinging. Set for the bottom of the third, and the batter will be the shortstop, Mason Wynn.
Mason Wynn.
And a 1-2. That's inside. To the right side, and that's just foul. The pitch. Just off the inside edge. Swing and a miss. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Now, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base paths, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
Left-hand batter waits. 3-2 now. On the ground to third. Throw on to Santana. Two up, two down.
Now batting, first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. His first at bat was a strikeout. And 1-2. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. And our score remains 2-1. And welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. And now it's Rowdy Tellez. Next pitch misses inside, and that's ball two. Yeah. drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. O'Neill going back on this one. Back some more. And he makes the catch on the track. Just missed a homer that time. That deserves another look. And StatCast showcases a great route and a lot of distance covered on the play. That was impressive, Chris.
Yeah, 115 feet to make the grab. And he had all the closing speed to pull it off. And that catch right there, I mean, that thing requires so much focus while the ball's in the air. I mean, you're running a long way. Your heels can hit, bobble your head a little bit. But he just put his athleticism on display for us on that one.
The 1-2. Center field. Dootbar to dead sprint. Makes a nice running catch. And there's two away.
The batter number two, second baseman.
Two outs, base is empty. Terang. Next for Milwaukee, Bryce Terang. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. The 1-1. Called strike right there.
One ball, two strikes.
Here comes a pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Gets a piece and stays alive. On the ground, right side. Edmund slings to first. Third out, and that ends the frame. Three up, three down that time. To the bottom of inning number four now. It's the Brewers 2 and the Cardinals 1. Welcome back. Bottom four. And stepping in for the Cardinals, Tyler O'Neill.
Tyler O'Neill.
Payoff pitch. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Got him out on the front foot. Couldn't keep the hands back long enough and played right into the hands of the pitcher.
Here's Nolan Arenado, and he's already singled in this game. Bounced out to short. Adames gets it to first. Already two gone here in the home fourth.
Number 40, Wilson Contreras.
And up to hit is Wilson Contreras. He's 0-1. The pitch. And there's a ball.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
Now front pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. And here it comes. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
So two down, Lucan Baker. Next up for the Cardinals. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. Ball and a strike. And strike two.
Generally, second, third time through the lineup, you want to be able to lean on those secondary pitches and command them. Looks like he's doing a nice job of it.
Next pitch is inside. 2-2. And now it's filled up.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
kicks and fires. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Monasterio puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. So one left for the Cardinals, and they trail it here, 2-1. Back here in St. Louis, top five, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Andrew Monasterio. And the pitch. This to third, Arenado. Fires across the diamond, one away here in the fifth.
The left fielder, number 22, Christian.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the left fielder, Christian Yelich. And the right-hander deals. Slider clips the zone. Movement in the bullpen for the Cardinals. Number 34 getting loose out there. King getting cranked up as well. Very high with that one. It's 2-2. Way inside, gets out of the way. And here's a 3-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. And there's ball four.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Up now for Milwaukee, William Contreras, 1-2.
He is a talented player. His big brother Wilson has a voice that his little brother may end up being better than he is.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
No, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow death. With two strikes, you're looking to protect, and halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
Next is switch hitting first baseman Carlos Santana. Michaelis checks over to first, and he's back. Next pitch is downstairs. Yelich off of first with two away. The 2-2. Yelich goes. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Nootbaar moves under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Milwaukee leaves one. They lead it 2-1. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. And here comes Tommy Edmond. The 1-1. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Santana puts it away, one away.
The right fielder, number 18, Jordan
Walker. Now it's the right fielder, Jordan Walker. Grounded out his first time up. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Mason Wynn digs in now. Went down on strikes his first time through. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. And that's downed away. And that one is lifted in the air. Yelich on the move. And that'll do it. So a lefty out of the pen, John King.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Well, one run game. Sal Frelick up now for the Brewers. Number 10,
Sal Frelick.
The lefty ready and a 1-1. In the air on the infield, makes the catch, and there's one gone.
Up next to Milwaukee, the shortstop, Willie.
Willie Adames up now for the Brewers.
Let's go, Cardinals.
And now the lefty.
That's a ball.
Bullpen activity starting up now. A right-hander is up and throwing. The 2-1. Foul ball there. The 2-2 now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The wind to kick the pitch. Line to right, and that'll be a base hit.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you gotta make them pay.
So here's the Brewers DH, Rowdy Tellez, and he's already left his mark on this game.
He certainly has, Boog. A two-run shot in the second inning, and that made an early impact on this game in a big way.
The pitch. Adames over at first with one away. And a ball evens the count. And that one hammered. That's back there. That'll touch down off the base of the fence. Cut off. Now a throw home.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way, but well, that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field.
So digging in, Mark Canna. And a pitch. And that's in the dirt. Runner at second here, one gone.
Let's get a K, come on.
And now it's 3-2. Go, ripped on a line, and a superb diving catch.
He takes a huge gamble right there. If that ball gets by him, the run scores easily from second, and the hitter maybe ends up on third. But a great job, excellent focus on the dive, and he robbed extra bases on that one.
Bryce Terang, the next to hit. Man at second. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. Well done behind the dish. The 2-1. And that one fouled off. Runner at second, two down. That one to first. Dives and he can't hang on. Not in time. Great effort, but it's an infield hit.
Just barely able to beat that one out. Man, he was giving it his all getting down the line right there. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Next for the Brewers, Andrew Monasterio. Here's a 1-1. Swings through that.
One ball, two strikes.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. Line drive, that's a base hit. Runner from third comes across. It's 4-1.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Back to the top of the Milwaukee order. Digging in, Christian Yelich. At the belt and fires. Good job to fight that one off. And a 1-2 again.
At the ball.
Bounce that off to the left, and we'll do it again.
You're always having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Comes a 2-2. Bounce to third. Slings it across. Yelich out on the play. They limit the damage here. So it's two runs on four hits. No errors and a couple left on. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Brewers 4 and the Cardinals 1. And welcome back at the play. Lars Nootbaar.
The center fielder.
Pitch misses inside, and it's 2-1. Bounced up the middle. Gathers and throws to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Now batting, first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. Misses off the plate. Now two balls and a strike. Swings through that one. Right back to him on the mound. in plenty of time to first, and they get Goldschmidt for the out.
Now batting, left fielder, Tyler.
Two outs, bases empty. And up next for St. Louis, Tyler O'Neill. 1-for-2 with a solo home run back in the first inning. The wind to the pitch. And that's ball four.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
And here comes the Brewers manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. That's as far as Wade Miley will go. It's a 3-run game, and we'll be back to tell you about the new arm in a minute. So they turn things over to the righty, Bryce Wilson.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of them right here to get some critical outs.
Here's the third baseman, Nolan Arenado. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner. Got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Next one off the plate inside, and it's 2-1. So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quickly react? And when you have good feet, you've got soft hands. And soft hand defenders are able to make tough plays look easy.
Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
When you look at the ability to save runs defensively, but then also put runs up on the scoreboard, that's the kind of player that every championship team needs to have.
And a pitch. And ball four, two aboard.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
So two on with two away. And here's the catcher, Wilson Contreras. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. That one missed.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Righty to the plate. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Abner Uribe, the rookie right-hander, is getting loose. Chafin warming up as well. Righty delivers. Ripped on the ground a second. Gets it to first. And Contreras is retired. Inning over. So the Cards strand a couple, and they trail it 4-1. Number 34 will take over here.
And he's got a big-time breaking ball to contend with. Hitters going to have to pick it up early if they're going to have any chance.
Now the number two hitter, William Contreras. 1-for-3.
Contreras.
And a 2-1 on the way. And it goes just foul.
Well, these Brewers, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. We've already seen 8 line drives from them, and it's always a good sign when the ball is jumping off your bat. And that's what this offense has been doing so far today.
Swing and a ball hammered left field. O'Neill going back, back some more. Reaching for it, makes the catch.
Gotta love the over-the-shoulder catch. I tell you what, those are really fun to make.
And now the first baseman, Carlos Santana. One now. Next offering is outside. Good eye right there. filled up.
Okay.
Swings through it for the K. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Great location with that two-strike fastball. I'll tell you what, as a hitter, you're looking to protect the outside part of the plate, stay back on something off speed. So many times, that location with two strikes, you just can't get around on it, and that's a tough one to compete with.
Here's a 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. One out to right. Walker gets under it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. Abner Uribe gets the call from the pen.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Brewers, number 45, Abner Uribe.
So now here's the Cardinals' designated hitter, Lucan Baker. Kicks and deals. Bounce to Santana. Takes it himself and one away in the bottom of the seventh.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Tommy Edmond.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Tommy Edmond. And a pitch. Fouls one off. 2-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone.
Oh, there he gets the slider in on his hands, and it just eats him up. You know, it's hard to get the bat around on a pitch like that in tight. You just feel like you're crowded on the inside part of the plate. Can't get any extension. That's one he definitely should have laid off of.
The 1-1. Fouled off down the right side. And it's
two
even
balls,
up.
Two strikes.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
Back here at Busch Stadium. Now it's the shortstop, Willie Adames.
Willie Adames.
The wind of the pitch.
Nope.
That misses, and now 3-1. And the righty deals. And it's fouled away. Payoff pitch, battling here as he fouls it away. Right-handed reliever, fouled off the plate, they'll do it again. Three, two, he goes down looking.
Yeah, that's a tough pitch to stay on. You don't want to get beat inside. And as you see that pitch continue to run away from you, by the time it's in the catcher's mitt, you think it's a ball off the plate away.
Rowdy Tellez up now for the Brewers. He's already homered here in this one. And a payoff pitch. Foul ball left side. He'll see another.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
A pretty good break on the curveball right there. Maybe not as down in the zone as he would have liked, but deceptive enough to get that swing and miss. And if you don't catch that pitch out front on the barrel, it bears in on you pretty hard.
2 down, nobody on. And another ball.
2-1.
That one the other way. He'll do it himself. Out number 3. Brewers go down quietly, but they lead it 4-1. Joel Piams takes over on the mound. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Joel Piams.
So digging in, Mason Wynn. The Cardinals in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at-bat out of him right here.
This one blasted deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. That was a moonshot, and they closed the gap. It's 4-2.
Just relentless. This team will not quit. He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
So up next, Lars Nootbaar. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
So important to get into the fielding position after you deliver that baseball. That is a scary one. Watch your lips.
And here's the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. And a 1-1. In the air to left center. Yelich makes the catch. 1 down.
Now batting left fielder, Tyler
O'Neill. Here's Tyler O'Neill. He's already homered in this game. Nootbaar at first, one gone. Pitch in for a strike, and the count's even at 2.
With 2 strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Swing and a miss. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike 3. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
And here is Nolan Arenado. Two outs. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Gassed it right by him. Cards claw back a bit on the homer. It's now 4-2. Back after this on the show. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, number 31.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
Up now for Milwaukee, Bryce Turang.
The second baseman, Bryce Turang.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. And that one just missed off the outside edge. On the ground to the left. And that's a fair ball.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
So, man aboard, Andrew Monasterio, up now for the Brewers. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And he deals. Stays alive. Nobody out. Runner at first. Swings and misses. Had him out front for strike three.
Just a hammer 12-6 curveball right there, Boog. That was exactly what he wanted to do with it. Not a ton of pitchers can throw a true 12-6 break, but he does, and you can't throw it any better than he did right there.
Ball to strike, the pitch. Slow ground ball to the right side, and he picks it up in foul territory. This one in the dirt. Nice job behind the plate there. Two two. That misses off the outside edge.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
Over to first, and he's saved. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. The 1-1 is fouled off. Step off throw to first, and he's back in safely. The pitch. Not even close there, and it's 3-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. They get a leadoff single but leave him stranded. 5, 6, and 7 will leave things off in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Brewers 4 and the Cardinals 2. Devin Williams into the game.
Save opportunity for him right here, and he's their guy. Time to lock this one down and get out of here with a W.
Number 38, Devin Williams.
And now, Wilson Contreras.
The Cardinals, the catcher, Wilson Contreras.
Hard hit, right side. Terang over to first in time. And Contreras is retired.
The designated hitter, Lucas Baker.
Here's the Cardinal DH, Lucan Baker. The pitch. That misses the zone. Two balls and a strike. On the ground. Throws to first. Cardinals now with just one out remaining.
The batter number 19, second baseman.
So two down now, and here is Tommy Edman. Falling behind 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. That just misses. Full count now.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
The right fielder, number 18.
And now Jordan Walker. The 1-1. Edmund off of first with two away. That misses, and the count is 3-1.
Big pitch coming right here. Last thing he wants to do is put the tying run on base, but he can't groove one either.
The tying run at the plate, and now it's filled up.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
And the tying run is on base.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Mason Wynn.
Coming off an absolute bomb in his last at-bat.
Swing and a miss, and that's the ball game.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
And your final 4-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon, for the victorious Brewers, 4 runs on 9 hits, no errors. They